This video on whole numbers looks at estimating and rounding. So why would we estimate? Often we don't need to know what the exact answer is. Sometimes near enough is okay. Like if you're trying to work out how many pizzas to order for a special lunch day or something like that, then it doesn't, the exact number of slices that people are going to eat doesn't matter. Near enough is okay, and it's easy, far, often it's far easier to work out. We can also use estimating to help us to check if a precise answer is correct. So you can estimate to then see, is your estimate near what your precise answer is, which can help you to decide, is my answer reasonable? How to round. So there are three ways of rounding. You can round up, you can round down, or you can round off. If you're rounding up, then raise the digit that you're rounding to up one, and then put zeros after that. If you're rounding down, then leave the digit as is and have zeros after that. To round off, look at the digit after the one that you're rounding to. If you're rounding off, if the digit after the one you're rounding to is 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, then round up. So change the digit before and then have up one and then have zeros afterwards. If the digit after the one that you're rounding off to is 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4, then round down. So leave the digit that you're rounding to as is and have zeros after that. When rounding a number off to a particular digit, we need to look at the digit that comes after the digit that we are rounding to. And these base 10 blocks that you might remember from primary school are going to help us to represent that. Let's say that we want to round off to tens. In that case, we'll need to look at the ones digit first. Here for 12, you can clearly see that 12 is closer to 10 than it is to 20. So that's 20, that's 10. 12 is clearly closer to 10 than it is to 20. It's less change to the number to lose 2 than it is to gain 8. Now we can see this clearly with the base 10 blocks, but we don't always use base 10 blocks every time we want to use a calculation or a rounding. So when you're doing this without blocks, you want to look at the digit after the one that you want to round to. So in this case, we want to round to the tens. So we look at the digit after that, which is the ones. If that digit is 4 or below, then leave the digit that you want as it is, which in this case is 1, and then put a 0 after it to mark the place. And you can clearly see that that 10 is much closer to the 10 blocks than the 20 blocks. In the case of 29, it can clearly be seen that 29 is much closer to 30 than it is to 20. So that's 20, that's 30. 29 is much closer to 30. It's less change to the number to gain 1 than it is to lose 9. So again, if we look at the digit after the one that we're rounding to, we're rounding to the tens, so we look at the ones digit, which is a 9, which is more than 5. Therefore, we need to raise the 10 digit up one to from 2 to 3, and then we make that one a 0 to mark place. Remember, if the digit after is 4 or below, then leave the digit as it is and then put the zeros to mark place. If the digit after is 5 or above, raise the digit up one and then put in zeros. If you find yourself getting confused,
Remember, you're trying to take it to the one that it's closest to. So draw or visualize your number with base 10 blocks like these.
Now we're going to have a look at some examples.
In this example, we've been asked to round the following numbers to their first digit. So if we look here at 271, we need to round to the first digit. So I'm going to look at the second digit, and then it doesn't, all however many digits there are after that, doesn't matter. So this is the digit I'm rounding to. So I look at this digit, which is 7, which is more than 5, which means I need to take it up. So I will then take that 2 up to 3 and then put zeros afterwards. Then you need to stop and think, is my answer reasonable? Is 271 closer to 300 or 200? And if you think about visualizing it, either on a number line or with base 10 blocks, 271 is closer to 300 than it is to 200. So our answer is reasonable. Example B, 3,194. I'm rounding to the first digit, so I need to look at the second digit, and then I can ignore all of the digits after that. The second digit is 1, which means we'll be rounding down. So we leave the first digit as is, and then we just put in zeros to mark place. Then we need to check and see if our answer is reasonable. 3,194, yes, that's closer to 3,000 than it is to 4,000, so our answer is correct. C is 551, which is right in the middle. So if you were asked to estimate, you could actually round this off to 550, but the question asks us to round it to the first digit, so that's what we're going to do. So we're rounding to the first digit, we look at the second digit, which is 5, so we need to take it up, so that will then become 600. Now 551 is only a tiny bit closer to 600 than it is to 500. If you were estimating, I would probably leave that at 550, but that's not what we've been asked to do, and we need to follow the instructions. For example D, we're asked to round to the first digit, and we've only got one digit, so the answer is 7. That's a bit of a trick question. You're asked to round off to the first digit, so the answer is 7, because that's all there is.
Estimating answers. Rounding off numbers can sometimes help us to do much easier numbers. This can help us when making predictions, and although sometimes you'll need to consider over or underestimating, for example, for ordering. So if we go back to our special lunch pizza analogy, we would want to make sure that we overestimate the number of pizzas that we would need to order, because we wouldn't want to underestimate, because then some people wouldn't get lunch. So sometimes you'll need to over or underestimate depending on the circumstances that your scenario is looking at. And we can also use estimating answers to help us to check a precise answer to see if it's close to what our estimated answer would be. Now we're going to have a look at some examples.
Estimate the following by rounding to the first digit and then calculating. So in this instance, we need to round off first. So 371, I'll round to the first digit. So I look at the 7 digit, which is 7. So I need to take that up to 400. 43, I'll look at the next digit, which is 3. So I'm going to take that down. So that will be 40. So I've rounded off, and now I can calculate an estimate. 400 times 40, I'm going to split that up and do 4 times 4 times 100 times 10, because that's an easier way to do the multiplication. 4 times 4 is 16, and then I have to times it by 100, and then times it by 10. So my answer is 16,000. Now, if I check the original sum on my calculator, 371 times 43, the answer won't be exact, but is it close? And our answer on the calculator is 15,953, which, yes, is very close to 16,000, so our answer is reasonable. For example B, again, the first thing we're going to do is round off to the first digit. So for 4,970, I can ignore anything that comes after the second digit. The second digit is 9, which means we're rounding up to 5,000. And then divided by 52, rounding to the first digit. So I look at the second digit, which is 2, which means I'm rounding down. So I leave the 5 as it is and then put a 0 afterwards. I've now got 5,000 divided by 50. I can cross off the same number of zeros for each one when I divide by 10. So I've now got 500 divided by 5, which I can do in my head as 100. If I was to check that answer on the calculator, remember it won't be the exact answer. We want to see if it's near enough. 4,970 divided by 52 gives us 95.57. If we rounded that off, we would round it off to 96, which is very close to 100. So our answer is correct. It is a reasonable estimate.
In summary, estimating is a useful mathematical skill. Near enough is often good enough for real life purposes. And we can also use estimating to check precise answers. You need to be proficient with rounding. And so in particular, remember when rounding off, look at the digit after the one that you're rounding to see what you need to do. I hope this video has been helpful looking at estimating and rounding.